win.
No.
How long is it for you? Wow. You must have got up early, huh? Cody Stemmler's work. Oh wow, polka dot. Those are the Canuck dye. Yeah. Oh, these are Zalmans.
I hope your video is recording.
Yes, I am. Oh wow.
Wow, that's great for that material. That's incredible.
This is Napa Valley.
Yep.
Stuff here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So they're a little weight stream tumbled. Yeah, this is,
look at that dovetail.
That's pretty nice.
Oh,
it's
going through. Yeah, that's silver sheen actually. Yeah.
That's pretty nice. That's nice quality.
Zalman, you wanna? Oh yeah, you got your cases.
I got more cases than this.
I brought a case just to show.
These are your artifacts here.
Yes, those are all artifacts.
Wow. Look at this guy before you slap it back in there. You're...
Oh yeah. Show the camera, Ken.
I don't want to hook anything here. Well, I think right here, let the maker.
Wow.
See if we can get the gold chain in it.
You might have to be coming from this side. There you go. Yeah, you have to come around this way.
Okay, let's see.
Where'd you find that?
Oh wow, yeah, it's popping. Yeah.
It's in right here.
Oh yeah.
Very nice. And you found that in a creek, right?
Yeah.
Very nice.
You know, I got tired of hacking these guys. I just
yeah. Those long drills, I mean, right?
Yeah.
5-inch drills.
But
oh,
I bought this one. I don't buy artifacts usually, but the dovetail.
Yeah, I was looking at that.
It was damaged, so I could afford it.
Yeah. Wow.
What's also some non-obsidian stuff here? Is it
a lot of it's Eastern stuff. Some of it's stuff that I've been gifted or bought. But this is Indiana. This is the Pecan. This is some Ohio stuff. Here's from Flint Ridge Blades. This is from my great-grandpa.
Oh, okay.
But this stuff looks mildly streamlined, bro. Especially some
a little bit,
yeah.
Come on, camera focus. Hold on. I'm trying to get the camera to focus on it. There we go. Wow, that's beautiful. What state is that?
This is Kentucky, I think. Kentucky or Indiana.
Yeah, material matches. Hornstone, I'm assuming.
Yep.
Yeah.
What else do you have in here? You have some.
No, this is just. I haven't found much. These are.
Yeah,
but.
These are recent.
Oh, some Napa brown obsidian point.
Yeah, that's an old
beautiful.
One.
That, yeah.
There's my most complete Stockton.
Yeah. Yeah.
Some old stuff, little dark point I found last summer.
Is this a lost lake here?
Yeah, but I think so.
Yeah.
That was given to me.
At one of the Napins or something?
From a relative who had a bunch of stuff in their basement.
Wow, that is really nice.
Mm-hmm.
That's really nice.
Wish it was whole.
You got a Montel base there? Whoa! Are you serious?
Yeah.
Wow. Is that an effigy? Oh.
No, it's impact fractures.
Oh my gosh.
Isn't that thing thin?
Wow, they weren't kidding when they said they would make him thin.
No,
oh my gosh,
thin.
I want to see this through the light. Wow.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Where'd you get that one?
That was from the same guy I got this from. He had a bunch of old stuff.
Wow. Yeah, and lots of Excelsior blades from Napa.
Yeah, lots of them. All these here are from the same.
This almost looks like a paleo kind of thing. It
yeah,
could just be a worn out.
Off.
Yeah. It looks
these
actually like it's just a really resharpened Excelsior.
I do have a couple.
You can see where it was in the haft still right there. That's super cool.
Here's,
is there a bevel on that? Little bit.
It's just twisted.
Yeah.
They weren't super concerned. Here's a little.
Whoa. Blade. Is that from Hopewell stuff?
No, this is a California blade.
Oh.
Here's a Humboldt drill.
Oh, yeah. Humboldts are definitely older.
Mm-hmm. Another Humboldt piece.
That's also from California?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's Franciscan.
I got some dirt on me. Yeah. That's some chunky stuff. That's tough to work.
Somewhere in the Napa source.
Where was that? Right over here?
Almost clear stuff.
Yeah.
I find a lot of the flakes.
Yeah. Are these Hopo bladelets?
Yep.
Wow. What's the story with this one?
It's from great grandpa. It's mold draw. It's off a spall.
So probably from Kentucky or so.
Yep. Ohio, actually. This is all central Ohio.
Nice. Very cool. Thanks for showing us.
Yeah.
Is this work from other people? This case over here?
This one's all other people's stuff.
Wow, you got them all labeled here? Mostly.
It's hard to take a good picture in the sun.
I know. Yeah. Well, I'm trying. Very nice.
What type of sun is this?
That's oil chert. Or
yeah,
actually?
Wyoming oil chert, yeah. That's actually a spall from a Folsom site. So I'm going to eventually have a Folsom made out of that.
So, Zalman, what's the story on this biface, partial biface?
It's a piece that was given to me from a collector.
Okay.
That had a whole bunch of broken stuff that I didn't want, so he gave it to me.
Wow, that's amazing. Here you go. Wow.
Amazing, right?
What the heck?
It's
me?
Unbelievable, man.
Never seen these before.
I've lost my teeth.
Look at that little Columbia. I think that's a Columbia, isn't it?
Or just a barbed point, a Gunther, or you want to call it a cup, or a what are they called?
That was Columbia Plateau or Gunther.
Yeah, yeah. Some quartz crystal in there.
Oh my god, he made Danish daggers too. Oh, hell.
That's so cool, man.
Franciscan shirt Danish daggers. Never seen something like that. That smell.
Yeah, Cahokia.
Look at that.
The Cahokia is amazing.
What's the smallest point in here? Probably that little guy right there.
Oh, I didn't even see that one.
Yeah.
I love the little stuff like this.
Goldstone.
Zalman?
Yeah, Zalman maybe.
Oh my gosh.
Wouldn't that be a snake handling or, you know, compatible activities?
So, I really need to work is all the. There's some Mexican items. What I really need to work out is all the Anadel sources.
Wow.
Then there's the and the other one mine is this Burdell Mountain that's I've seen mentioned, but that's for I heard is super.
I was just on
hike. Yeah, coming soon. This is all obsidian from one source. Different colors, different patterns. Zalman, you wanna say anything?
Yeah.
Made them,
just
huh?
Lots of collecting.
Yep. Very nice.
Half, it'll float, yep.
Yeah.
Give me my biface.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, soft.
So the stone axe head fell into water that we thought was a lot shallower directly than it actually ended up being, and here's Zalman retrieving it.
We need goggles or something.
Oh, you feel it? You get it?
Did you get it? You got it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Dan.
If there's anyone who's going to find a rock, I know it's Zalman.
And I think that to be successful with a deadfall, you need to have it fall just a small distance.
Okay. The problem with that is getting in there with your hands to set the
yeah.
trigger on it.
Yeah.
But you're right. That's logical.
It's easy.
And I tried narrowing the access so that it couldn't go out the sides, but that didn't work.
It's easy to say it was wrong, but I haven't been as successful.
Well, then the little bastards insulted me. They built a nest in my woodshed,
uh-huh.
and they used everything that they could find in my woodshed. So when they...
Go ahead.
So you're coming out?
Yep.
And this will make a knife handle too.
Yep, sure.
You're going to have to edit this severely here before public showing.
Yeah. Okay, there we go.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Wow. Okay.
Yep.
Great.
And now fairly coarse haft. Now you peel it, shape it, do what you like with it.
Cool, okay.
And then you can cut this off wherever you want the length of the handle.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Uh-huh.
Look how easily this comes off.
All right, let's have some of that bark.
Yeah.
See if I can't.
Yeah, I mean, you can make really good willow bark cordage.
All I can do is demonstrate the process.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. We'll go on to something else.
Yep. That's what Ishi said too, I think.
Uh-huh.
A nice float.
He got it.
Got it?
I think so.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like a legend, man. It really is.
It's magic.
Woo!
Almost went all the way through.
This is the stuff Jimmy gave us. Yeah.
It's basically the black from the fire.
Yeah.
With dogs.
Oh, with dogs. Okay.
I have spot and stalk.
Nice. Beautiful.
Direction.
They need to
like have your a big swing and you're hitting down tends to make this ball more curved, but more straight in tends to make this ball go a little bit more straight.
Which is airborne.
Big more mass makes it easier just to go up. You just to go up, go straight.
I didn't move that.
Refund.
Well,
you already
put a mic at them, just to leave it to see if they're okay.
Yeah, but you.
Pyroid surface here. It's fatty. Look at fatty.
I have a happy cat.
I like to see a happy cat. You want to go now? Hey,
what's that material?
I didn't know what it was. According to John, I think it's some kind of shirt from Oklahoma or something.
From Flint Ridge, he said.
Oh, it's Flint Ridge, yeah.
I don't know about Flint Ridge.
Well,
that's
what he said. That's what John said.
Well, maybe, but...
looks like it's got some issues in it, yeah. Huh.
Pretty coarse.
Yeah.
Where'd you say it
Flint
was?
Hills. Flint Hills, not Flint Ridge.
Oh, Flint Hills.
Flint Hills.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
K County.
From Kentucky or?
No.
Oh, wait, no. Oklahoma.
Kansas, Oklahoma.
Oh, Kansas.
Flint Hills is Kansas.
Oh, that's confusing. Kansas, Oklahoma.
Had a crack in that sucker.
It's got that. It's got that really fine. Vein. Layering in it.
Yeah.
seasons change. All the year, he starts in the spring and he finishes in the late.
Zalman, the apocalypse isn't here yet.
Yeah, we can make it start.
So is this a fishing spear?
It's just kind of a combination of
Macaweedle and a spear.
Yeah.
Wow.
I used the saguaro rib, cactus rib for the handle.
Let me get a bye face real quick. Finally, a utilitarian bye face.
I haven't been wasting time here.
Oh, nice.
You want to show the camera?
Oh, I'll show the camera.
So Ken's been working on some Canuck D.
He's always been his career.
You see this?
He enjoys it. He's doing well. So.
If you get a chance to go out of the bridge, then I can make his father.
Yeah, I've been when the partner is transferred. You know, he can just,
I've done that, you know, and I have like two small ones.
But it's got colors in it like I've never seen out of Altura. Gotta get it right.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Isn't that cool?
I'm working
on it. Obviously, I don't have it on the line. I just pulled a piece off. I think you're here.
Yeah.
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 Tell me when you can see some of that.
Turn this way. Yeah. Oh,
Mikey,
yeah.
You just gotta do it more often, bud.
Wow.
Mexican rainbow. I'm glad you make it. The old quality stuff.
Beautiful. Wow.
The original point, John at Richardson's Rock Ranch.
Oh, right, right. He's got all that fire opal or sun opal or sunset opal.
They have the opal bits right in the Richardson sunset jasper.
Wow.
You want to take some of these out and show them for me?
Now the sun's coming out.
Yeah.
Some of them have very spectacular colors.
Oh yeah.
Some of them might be more average.
Yeah. When did you become interested in this narrow entry Ishii work? Because I remember seeing a lot of your YouTube videos. You've got some pretty old ones.
I heard about them originally from my grandfather. I was probably, I don't know, a toddler at the time.
Oh, really? Okay.
Talking about how they discovered some wild Indian in California and making arrowheads and all. It wasn't the exact story, but good enough to pique my interest.
Yeah.
My grandfather had an artifact collection.
Wow.
So.
Mind if I take one of these out?
I'll go for it. Now I moved to Denver, Colorado back in the mid-80s, and my friend's dad was a Flint Napper and used to leave obsidian laying around, so I used to play with that.
Okay. Then and what age were you?
Huh?
What age were you then?
Oh, see, I was born in 78, so it's been a while.
Yep. But you were a young boy then?
Yeah.
Wow.
And then probably around, I want to say 2000 or so, I went to Davis Creek and drove back to Sacramento to my brother's house. And then the neighbors like, have you ever tried your hand at napping? And I said no. So I had a bunch of obsidian laying around, and then years and years later I decided to try working some of it.
Wow. So you started at, how old were you, would you say, when you first started napping arrowheads?
Sometime in my 20s.
Okay. Nice.
Of course, the sun not cooperating.
Yeah.
I would say this is probably some of the better flaking
that I've
done.
Yeah, I was looking at
that
one, yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah. If the sun was cooperating a little bit better, you could see all the nice color.
Yeah.
But I don't grind the edges, as you know.
Right. You just do an up pick.
At least
method.
Not for.
Like a lot of the natives did.
Yeah, I'm just looking at the other stuff, and I can see that they weren't really grinding like we do these
exactly.
days.
I was telling John Whitaker about that, and how some of the, a lot of the artifacts you find have that up-pick method, where the edge kind of has right. that basically seamless edge.
Or at a minimum, yeah. they were just using the tip of the antler
right.
to get a bite.
Right, exactly. An antler is really good for that.
I would say, yeah. This one probably has a more precise flaking pattern. Mm-hmm. Of course, that's, you know, the opposite approach, which right. is to grind the whole preform, right. cheating, as they say.
More of a fong flaking yeah. pattern. Yeah. Wow. And do you, and I remember seeing you use antler on some of the fog preforms you do. Is that, you do that commonly?
Some of them I do. Mm-hmm. This one has some problems on the base there.
What's the advantage of doing antler? It just holds well, better? Or?
I'm trying to see if I can find one. I might have done this one with antler. Mm-hmm. It's just a different look.
Yeah, it does.
And I thought I had a cast in here. Uh-huh. Maybe I don't, but if you were to look at some of the original ishy points and compare mm-hmm. them, it's more of just a, like a random flaking pattern.
Right.
I know he used steel on a lot of them, but I'm pretty sure he still used antler once in a while.
Yeah.
But for me, it's just a different flaking pattern. You're not going to get them as clean and precise.
Right.
You know, all stacked one on top of the other, nice and perfectly.
Wow. And what's your technique for notching? Because you're doing narrow entries, so you're starting out with like a really small chip, obviously, and then you're, are you popping them from above just to, or are you in the notch actually still
hold
with the antler?
Between the thumb like this with a piece mm-hmm. of leather, mm-hmm. and I have a little pin vise with a piece of eighth inch mild steel, uh-huh. hammered flat and filed sharp, and then mm-hmm. just come in from the side. Wow. Clean it up on each side, yeah. flip it over,
wow.
take another one, clean up each side, yeah. rake the inside a little bit, flip it back over. You just wow. have to be careful not to twist the piece with your fingers.
Right.
It has to be supported pretty much perfectly.
Yeah.
Your support has to be right on the money.
Right in the base there?
Like yeah. Right, you have to spend more time setting everything up just to get it just right so you don't snap it.
Right
across the base. Once I get it in there a little bit farther, then I support it on my leg like mm-hmm. this.
Oh, sideways?
I can come in like this, and I can clean up.
Oh, you're like
the
pushing
edges.
The point into your tool.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm kind of roll it in, wow. pop off little flakes, and that's how I open them up.
Yeah. And is that the sense. Narrowest entry notch one you have in this case?
Oh, it's or? Probably one of them.
Yeah.
I mean, if you look at that one, it's...
That's super, super fine.
It's pretty small.
Yeah. It's amazing.
Honestly, though, I don't go for the most narrow. If you look at a lot of Ishii's points, they're more something like this. And I would consider this to be one of my more accurate
Ishii points.
It's probably my favorite one.
Yeah.
And the notches aren't super duper tight. I didn't want them to be.
Yeah.
Because I don't like the way it looks as much as having...
Right. Because you exactly because you can't really see if they're too tight, like some of the ones that like Mike Cook does and a couple of the other pog guys, they're just too tight. You can't even see where the notch starts.
Yeah, it's a challenge.
Yeah,
you know, to see how tight you can get them. I noticed on some of the Ishii points, the originals, one of them would be real narrow and the other one blew out.
Yeah,
and you just open it up anyway.
Yeah.
It looked kind of odd, but they're still really cool.
That's amazing. The colors are astounding. I mean. I'm trying to get the
hands. Some of this Mexican rainbow just had to die for colors.
Yeah. Wow, beautiful.
This is the old stock royal peacock that everybody's fighting over.
Really?
Yeah. People losing friendships and going to war with each other over this stuff.
Yeah.
I don't care as long as I got enough to keep me happy.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, I'm not too familiar with all the different kinds of the rainbow, but
There's other stuff in here. Of course, the sun's not cooperating. This is actually a piece of electric blue that you can't see.
Lassen Creek.
Yeah, gotta have sunlight.
Yeah.
There's some Napa chocolate.
Oh, that's nice stuff. The brown. Beautiful. Well, you know what's really cool is there's so many varieties. I'm sure Zelman was showing you.
Oh yeah.
The Napa varieties. And is it true that Ishii said that this is one of his favorite materials to nap, or is that just...
That's what I heard. a lot of the material that they brought to him was actually from Napa.
Yeah, because I mean that's one of the closest sources to Berkeley, right?
Yeah, they would bring it to him because he didn't have any rock apparently. But yeah, some of these rainbows are just really bright.
Which one would you say are your top three favorites in this case?
Well, this one actually was until I dropped it on the floor. Oh. I don't know what happened, but the ear popped off.
Oh, that's, well, at least it was just the ear, I guess, huh?
Yeah, Lassen.
Purple.
Purple.
Whoa.
Wow. I really liked that one until I dropped it. That was a bummer.
Do you like it because of the stone or the flaking or both?
A little bit of both.
Oh.
So there's that one, and then there's, I would have to say this one's in there.
Oh yeah,
just because
I think I've seen that one on your Instagram.
Wow.
Yeah, it's got a lot of color.
The flaking, the parallel.
The flaking is pretty crazy.
Oblique flaking, yeah. Beautiful.
That was when I was
really doing a lot of Ishii stuff. Gorgeous.
Kind of peaked out on that one, and then I already showed you, this is probably my favorite Ishii point.
Wow.
That I have.
And that's also Mexican there?
Some of the very first Mexican rainbow I ever got.
Wow.
I was pretty happy when I got a point out of it.
Beautiful. Yeah, is this blue one the one from your YouTube video?
No, I started to work on one and then I never finished it apparently. At least I didn't break it. This is one of my older ones.
Uh-huh.
And this is when I was just trying to go for like an exact replica.
What Ishii was doing.
Probably the best Ishii point I ever made was actually this one that was cast, but I gave it away. But this was...
Whose collection is that in?
Richardson Rock Ranch.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah. So, hey, at least I have a cast.
Well, now you can just say it's Silver Sheen Obsidian.
Or something. Everybody always points those out. Hey,
yeah. That's pure silver, huh?
Yeah, this is the one I traded the guy for to do the cast.
Wow, yeah.
That was actually a nice point. I was pretty happy about that. This early fog work, nothing great.
Right.
It got better as time went on.
Yep. Beautiful. Well, thanks for showing me, Jimmy.
Oh, you're very...